My name is Robin Webb. I am a postdoctoral fellow in Steve Stice's lab in the Regenerative Bioscience Center here at the University of Georgia. I grew up in a small town called Olive Hill, Kentucky, about 80 miles east of Lexington. So I did work at a couple different vet clinics through high school and college. That was my first introduction to science in a professional setting, a clinical sort of setting. I definitely had some catching up to do when I got to college. My introductory to biology class was one of the most difficult classes I have ever taken, and it was a huge challenge to get caught up, but it was a class that definitely changed the direction of the rest of my, not only my college career, but my career in general. I wanted to get some laboratory technician experience, and I applied to a job at the University of Kentucky and got a call back from Paul Murphy in Sanders Brown, the Center on Aging. So I took a job as a laboratory technician in a lab that does Alzheimer's disease research, which had a profound impact on me because I have a sibling who has Down syndrome, and I was aware that people with Down syndrome start developing Alzheimer's disease pathology as early as their 40s. So I have several different projects in the lab. One is exosome secretion. And exosomes are small signaling molecules that are secreted by cells, and kind of a new way we're learning that cells kind of talk to each other in their surrounding environment. And so what we're interested in is if you have cells that are communicating, they're secreting these exosomes and they're telling each other, we're diseased. Can we change that conversation? Can we take exosomes from a neural stem cell or a differentiated neuron and say, we're healthy? I do like the hands-on part of research. I love training and being involved with graduate students and undergrads. I like collecting data and being the hands-on sort of in the middle of everything part of it. I also love the artistic parts of science. I love making figures and taking that data and making it something you can communicate to other people. It definitely inspires me to be involved with projects that are going to have an impact on people's lives, you know, within our lifetime. And science is now, it's developing at such a rate that the things that we're doing now in the lab, I mean, we're going to see the impacts of these things in our lifetime. And that's exciting. And the chance to do work that pays it forward to the next generation and adds quality to people's life, you know, not just years, but actual ability to be on their own, be independent, maintain their mental health and their memories, that's so important and it's so needed.